Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Rigging on Thursday with the Coach. We're trying something a little bit different today. I got my man Jordan on live in color here. And what we're going to do is try a little question and answer show today. And that's something we've been wanting to try to do for a while and do it a little different. And so y'all need to get your questions in, and we're going to try to cover as many questions as we can as they come in to you. But before we do, I just got a couple things I want to show you today. We've got a really neat decal we're now selling. It's I think with how dollar for half. They're not very expensive anyway. It looks real good on the gun of the boat or in the back windshield of your truck. If you're interested in wearing a big, or running a big bite decal, check with us on this. We'd love to put your hands on one of these for sure. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then today I just want to talk about what's the hottest thing on the market right now. So I kind of gauge this, Jordan, off of what goes on each week. But for the last 2 weeks, obviously the water's beginning to warm just a little bit. I know here the water's in the high 40s. Mm-hmm. So chatterbaits. Everybody's talking about chatterbaits. So I just want to go back over and show you three quick colors. Obviously, if you're running a chatterbait, then I recommend the jackhammer. And then I also recommend our swim on to go on the back of it. That's what we're getting to is the swim on for sure. So anyway, I was just going to show you three setups real quick that we had back from our show we did earlier. And we'll probably come back and do that show again because it's that time of year and it's real informative. But here's your pearl swim on your pearl chatterbait or your white chatterbait. And if your water's not real muddy, then that'd be a real good choice. It's pretty muddy down here where we're at right now. And it seems like what's really hot is out there is everybody's wanting red. Mm-hmm. So, you got your craw and then you got your, flamethrower swim on the back of it. So definitely we also make that green pumpkin flamethrower. This is one of our top selling colors right now. Yeah. And then the old standby in muddy water and cold water, black and blue with a black and blue swim on it. So that's just three I wanted to show y'all today. Just basically, I try to throw that on like a medium heavy rod. I like a 7.2 rod, throw it on with some 17 pound fluorocarbon and just an average speed reel. It can, just fish it slow. Make sure you fish it slow. But that's, that's what's up. That's what's really raging right now. That's what everybody's buying for sure.
For sure.
Okay, question time. All right, so today what we'd like to do is just answer some questions and see how it goes. And we might try to do more of these in the future. We kind of sprung this on you a little bit. We were going to put a big thing up on the internet about it, and it's been crazy right here. We're really busy. And let's go ahead and get started. What kind of questions we got?
Sure. So how about first, before we answer the first one here, let's give something away. What do you think?
We can do that. So for the fifth person that texts or messages Jordan, hello, I'll give you a 40% discount Big Bite card. You can redeem it on our website. It'll get you a 40% discount on anything you want to buy. So first, the fifth person, so you better do it now.
Yeah, put it in the chat. Right. And the fifth person in the chat here will.
Okay, sounds good. All right, good. All right, what we got now? Let's talk about it.
We have a ton of questions.
Great, y'all keep them coming. We're not going to get to all of them, but we're going to just kind of highlight the ones we grab real quick and go with it.
Okay, so let's start. Let's see. Let's go with this one from Nathan.
All right, Nathan.
He wants to know, what is your favorite color to use for a soft plastic?
Probably overall my favorite color is tilapia.
Yeah.
But it's hard to get away from a black and blue color too. So my rule of thumb usually is in muddy water, I go with a darker color. In regular water, what I call regular water, not necessarily clear water, but just a little bit stained, I like some type of green pumpkin. So I use the tilapia, I use the hematoma.
Okay. Let's see, let me pull up this next one here.
Okay. All right, good.
First off, we have...
Yeah, he's trying to. We're trying. We'll be a little technical here and there today.
Sam Thrax is the winner for this week.
Okay, good. All right, Sam Thrax, you got it. We'll get it out to you. You need to send us your address. We'll take care of you on that.
Here's a good question.
All right,
from Preston wants to know, what is your PB?
What's my PB, Preston? 11.2. Mm-hmm. 11.2. So I'd like to catch one bigger than that. But right now it's 11.2.
Yep, mine's right about the same actually.
Yeah, awesome.
And what's funny actually for mine. My PB before that was like 6 pounds.
Yeah, but you got a great story with that fish too. Tell that story about how you caught it and took it around and had it weighed and it showed back up 25 miles away. Yeah, that's pretty right. Neat.
I caught mine on Toledo Bend. This has been, I guess, probably 4 or 5 years ago now, but caught it on a big swim bait at night. And the funny part about that was Toledo Bend has a lunker program to where they tag big fish. And that way you can release them, you get a free mount, that whole deal. But the whole point of that is so that it incentivizes you with a free mount so that you put the fish back instead of keeping it, mounting it. That way the big fish stay in the lake. But anyways, all that to say, we're calling around to different marinas. Like I said, it's nighttime, so no one was available. Everyone was closed. There was one marina open, and it was on the whole other side of the lake.
So y'all drove all around the lake to take the fish to have it weighed. And then I'm assuming they turned it loose there after they tagged it.
Yeah. And then, we drove all the way around the tip, all the way into Louisiana, because we were on the Texas side to Little Bend. If you've ever been there, it's a massive lake, okay? So we got all the way over to Louisiana, released the fish there for the, so we could have the paperwork saying we released.
And how many weeks later?
And then, I don't know, it was probably a couple months later.
It was caught back in the same area where you caught it originally. Another guy took it and weighed it and put a tag on it. So that's pretty neat. Exactly. So if you ask the question, do bass go back home? There's your answer.
Yeah. We released it in Louisiana and it swam all the way back to Texas and got caught again. So
that's crazy. That's a good story, though, I tell you. I like that first time I heard it. No doubt. Let's get back to the questions. What we got?
Let's see. How about, man, we have so many questions. How about some winter bass fishing tips?
My biggest tip on winter is just slow down. Okay. I don't normally change my baits a whole lot. I just slow down. I think the slower you can get, because that water's cold, those fish are lethargic, so you want to slow down. And I tend to think something, maybe a flash or vibrate or make a real good rattling sound works much better in the cold water. Okay. Seems to anyway, for sure.
Well, that's good to know.
What's your favorite trailer to use? Depend on the apparatus I'm using on. If I'm throwing a swim on, I really began to like this. I can tell you, not a sales pitch. I like this. If I'm throwing a swim jig, I like some type of crawl trailer on it. Fighting frog or either kamikaze crawl. So, you can do, that's just two examples of things you could use.
Okay, how about, what is your favorite lure?
Wow, that's kind of tough. If we're talking about a hard bait, a crankbait of some variety, probably. I mean, I catch a lot of fish on crankbaits. I tell you, in the summer, a lure I like that we make a lot is that toad buzz.
Yeah.
It works real good. If you like topwater action, that works real good. I like to throw that a lot.
Okay. Here's an interesting question. What is Big Bite's most popular baits?
Trick stick is the number one, has been for years. Suicide shad sells real good. The fighting frog, those are three real standbys. But now here in the last year or so, that swim on has really gained it. And in the last 6 months, the BFE has done really well. So that's some of the things that we're selling really well, I think.
Okay. Let's see. How about, what is your favorite stick bait color?
I like to throw green pumpkin, just a straight green pumpkin stick. That just seems to be the one I get the most bites on. A lot of guys will tell you watermelon red. That's the old school color, But I like a green pumpkin. I think it works pretty good for sure.
Let's see. Okay, here's a little bit different change of pace.
All right, good.
How about your favorite hard bait? I guess you answered that.
Sorry. Well, I can answer that. That's not a problem. My favorite hard bait, I like a 6XD. Okay. Strike King 6XD is what I'd use most of the time if I'm not throwing a plastic or some variety.
Okay. We have Clem Andrew. What is the best time to throw a finesse jig?
Well, I think that also has to do with your lake. Now, I would never, and this might be, this is old school, and I'm stuck in my ways, but I would never go out here hardly and throw a finesse jig.
Right.
Because there's lots of big fish out here, and I want them to bite, so I like to throw them something big and bulky, okay? But now, if I was in a lake that had lots of spotted bass or smallmouths, I'd throw a finesse jig quite a bit. Mm-hmm. And, I think a typical rule is, late spring, early spring, late spring, summer type pattern. And, we got that new kamikaze crawl that you can put on the back of it that's a 3-inch model.
Yep.
But I hardly ever throw any type of finesse baits out on this lake. I power fish where I'm at here most of the time.
Right. Okay, so it might be a regional thing.
That's right. It could be.
Okay. Here's a good question from Colin.
All right.
What is your favorite jig?
Favorite jig. Okay. I like an all-terrain is the one I use all the time.
So is it like a football head?
It's a football head jig. Okay. If I'm doing a swim jig, I usually use a dirty jig.
Okay.
Swim jigs.
So maybe talk about different type of.
Well, usually on that football jig, I usually put a fighting frog on the back of it. That seems to be the trailer I like the best. But now on the swim jig, I like something that flaps. So lots of guys do it different. A lot of them put like a swim bait on the back of it. They might put like a finesse swimmer on it. I like things that flap and give it the craw type look.
Right.
So normally I put like a kamikaze craw on it, something like Yo Daddy, something that's going to give some kick. But you can do either way. And you actually can put a swim on the back of it. Now, I haven't tried that, but I've talked to some guys who have been trying that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm kind of hard to teach an old dog new tricks. So I just kind of like something that flaps on my swim jig. I don't know why. That's just me. So definitely.
Here's a great question we definitely have the answer to. Aldrick is wondering, do y'all make chatterbait trailers?
Oh, yeah, right here. The swim on, Aldrick. You need to get you some of them if you hadn't got them already. 4.25 swim on that is designed as the chatterbait walks left to right. The swim on does it, swims behind it. So definitely you need to get some of those. I promise you, you will be satisfied.
Absolutely. Okay, let's see. Man, they're pouring in here.
Good, good, good.
Let's do a few more of these.
Give us a couple more. Let's do them.
How about your favorite moving bait?
I like to use a popper if I'm moving on top of the water. Other than a buzz bait, I like to use a popper, like a Rico popper. I do real well on poppers. They seem to work real good on moving type bait on top of the water. I know in a lot of lakes, guys use a lot of walking type baits. Now, we don't use a lot of them here, but lakes that have like hydrilla and grass in them, they'll throw that walking bait up over the top of that grass and do real well with it.
Right.
Of course, we don't have that kind of grass here, so you catch them on a popper, usually earlier, or a buzz bait seems to work real good. Or some type of frog, like a Sproul walking frog. That's another standby that I always have on the deck of my boat when the water begins to warm up.
Okay. Ty Hari is wondering, do y'all make spinnerbait trailers?
We do make some things that you can use as a spinnerbait trailer. We have, if you like a curly tail approach, we have a finesse grub that you can use.
Yep.
And we also have the old timey, I call it the curl tail grub, like a 4-inch curl tail that comes in a bunch of colors that you can put on the back of a spinnerbait. But we're technically testing and thinking about coming out with a new spinnerbait trailer. That's one of the things that we've kind of got targeted for this year. So definitely keep a watch. I actually, me and you both, tested one of them the other day a little bit, and I think it's going to be really good. So keep an idea. It's going to be a kamikaze spinnerbait trailer, basically.
Basically, yeah.
Yeah.
And so another little tip that people might not know, if you take actually the shorter tour swim worm and you cut
it chop it off and make it like a paddle tail behind it. That works pretty good,
that
too.
That looks pretty good, too.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, let's talk about creature bait. So what is your favorite creature bait color?
Color?
Yeah.
I can go back to the same thing. If it's in the summertime months, it's clear, I'd use like a green pumpkin variety of some type. And in the spring, when it's basically muddy normally here, I'd go with a black neon hematoma, something that's dark.
Right.
Definitely. I like to use that old standard, what we call our creature,
yep,
which is a brush hog style bait. It pulls pretty good on the Carolina rig and works real well.
Right.
Definitely.
Okay, here's an interesting one from Owen Brown. What is your favorite small presentation bait?
If you want to downsize and get something that's compact, it works pretty good, that we make, the Yo Daddy. I think it is a real good compact bait. It's not near as big in stature. I know that Russ Lane developed that for that reason. I know if you flip and pitch or punch, it works extremely well, and I highly recommend trying that. It's got a little bit of meatier body, too. It's pretty neat.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Here's an interesting one. Jan is wondering, are there any good bass/bluegill lures? So maybe like a lure that could catch both?
Yep.
Like a fat grub, probably.
Yeah, probably a fat grub. You'd say that. My daughter caught like an 8-pounder off the dock fishing for crappie on a 2-inch fat grub. So you could try that. I mean, that's kind of hard, but definitely something smaller, obviously.
Sure. All right, let's answer a couple more here.
All right, good.
King James. What is your favorite wintertime bait?
I like to throw an Alabama rig in the winter.
Okay, yep.
Give them that shad look. Give them a group of shad, because they're kind of sluggish anyway. You can throw that, and it seems to work pretty good for me.
Right. And yeah, I would say definitely.
We did a show on that. They want us to go back and look at that. Was it 2 weeks ago? We did a show on the Alabama rig. Take a look at that. It's got some pretty good tips and ideas in it. Definitely.
Okay, let's do this one for the last one. Do we have any speed worms?
We have what we call a tour swim worm.
Yep.
It's the same thing as a speed worm. It's different, however, the way it's constructed.
Mm-hmm.
It has a lot of action. And the thing I think is really neat about our tour swim worm, it comes in two sizes, a 5.5 and a 7.5. But the thing I think is really neat about it is its tail is detachable.
Yeah.
So you can tear it all the way to an open V. You can tear it part of the way, or you can leave it attached. So if you want a straight swim worm that has no V in it, you can use it that way. Or if you want to tear it all the way and make it, where it kicks more, you can do that. And you can kind of adjust your presentation to how you like it. That's what I like about it. So yes, definitely. Tour swim worm, 7.5, 5.5. We do have that for sure.
It's like two or three actions in one, basically.
That's right, yes. It's got a lot of head action, too. That's what I like about it. Not just the tail flaps, that head kind of swims, too. Mm-hmm. Works pretty good.
Okay.
So... Somebody asked what type of fluorocarbon do we use. We recommend Sunline, no doubt. They're friends with our company. We recommend Sunline to you of any variety. I like the Shooter the best, but it's the most expensive brand. But there's some other Sunlines that work real well, but try Sunline fluorocarbon. It throws really well.
Yeah. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you want to wrap it up there?
We can wrap it up there. We're going to do this again. We just kind of wanted to do this today as a test. It's been very successful. We appreciate everybody calling in. If we didn't get your question, we're sorry. Like I said, this was kind of a trial and error type deal. We're going to try to maybe work on this a little bit more and do this more often and just talk about a lot of different things to do with fishing. So definitely look forward to doing this again. We appreciate seeing everybody today, and good luck with your fishing, and hopefully the water's going to get warm and the temperature's going to get warm and we're good and everything. So till next week, See you here at Big Bite.